Hey everybody out there in YouTube land, this is Jen and Christian's with me, and it is another one of our 31 days of Halloween. So if you guys want to hear Christian's pick and our thoughts on Dream Home, stick around.
This movie raises an interesting question. What would you be willing to do in order to achieve what you want in life? A topic we've seen tackled a few times in horror, but I think this movie does it in a very interesting way.
Well, I would drown Jake and kill you if it got me an Irishman.
Well, Jesus fuck, this just got really fucking dark. Okay. So I'm gonna ignore that now, and all that fun stuff. But yeah, so anyway, Dream Home. This is a Hong Kong slasher film from 2010. And, this is a movie that I don't really hear many people talk about, nowadays. I only sort of kind of knew about the film through hearing it through random recommendations and a couple, lists and a couple people's just like, who were into like more underground horror films, recommendation videos. And yeah, this was a movie I was always interested in, and finally having seen it, yeah, I can see why people would dig this one.
Yes, this one is, if you like your gore and your bloody and your special effects and your slashers, you're gonna have a fun time with this one. I had never heard about this either. Christian, it had been on Christian's to watch list for quite a long time, guys, and we just figured this is like the perfect time to finally clear it off of our backlog. And I'm really glad you showed it to me, because I didn't know what we were I thought we were gonna go for a very different premise than the one
as
we got.
I honestly, like, this is a movie I'd only see, a couple years back when I finally had a copy of the movie, I did watch the opener of the film, which is a great way to get an audience hooked, and it was going to be a part of a previous 31 Days of Halloween, but life things happened and we didn't end up doing it as a part of that marathon. But it always stuck in my mind, especially with that opening, because our opening is great. Our opening is just a security guard sleeping and then get someone putting a zip tie around their neck and suffocating them, and they have to cut the zip cord off with a box cutter and also slashing their own throat. It's a great, super memorable way to get the audience's attention for the movie, and really sets the picture of what kind of movie we're doing.
It's definitely an attention grabber, that's for sure. And the movie definitely hooks you from the beginning, mm-hmm. and really doesn't let you go. See, I was going in thinking that this has to be a husband, because Dream Home, you think this has to be a couple and a partnership, and I like the fact that it's actually just a young woman on her own.
Yeah.
Sisters are doing it for themselves. We don't need no man!
Which is definitely something very different, but also reflecting the time. This was made in 2010, but reflecting the world, that how the world was shifting, especially in areas like Hong Kong, which is, it's really kind of cool to see all that stuff. The movie does, I don't know what I was expecting with this movie, but I wasn't expecting the movie that I ultimately ended up getting, but I'm really glad with I really like the direction the movie goes into.
You like the movie we got?
Yes,
I did too.
So.
I did too. It's very, this is a very, weird movie, and I don't mean that in a bad way, but I mean that tone-wise is interesting, because we do have some kind of funny kind of cutaway gags. There are some kind of funny stuff with the gore and slasher elements, but then there is also some very deeply introspective moments of it too. It's a very interesting mix.
It's both weird in a tone sense as well as in a narrative sense. The movie is all over the place with its narrative, and I mean that in a positive way. The movie jumps back and forth between time a lot, and I think it works to it kind of discombobulates the movie you initially when you kind of get used to it as the movie does it more and more, and just kind of telling the story of in present this what we follow a woman named Li Sheng, and she, ever since she was a child, really wanted to live in a nice apartment that had a view of the ocean, and everything was going to be wonderful because that was going to fix all of her life's problems. And now, as an adult, she's killing people to achieve that goal.
Since she's been a child, her father told her, if you study hard and make money, you can have a room of your own. In a weird way, what this movie kept reminding me of, in a weird way, is Little Shop of Horrors.
Oh.
Somewhere that's great. Oh. I kept wanting her to sing that.
Oh, very much so. This is all, you're not wrong, honestly. I was kind of having those thoughts as well. The movie very much is about, like, okay, yeah, if you were, the idea of, oh, yeah, if you work hard enough and you put your all into it, you will get what you want in life. And in reality, no, probably not. Probably no matter how hard you work, you're still going to end up in abject poverty and you're never going to achieve what you want in life unless you have to do some shady underbelly shit or go as far as Li Sheng does of just killing people to lower property value. The movie was written and created during the housing crisis, and the movie set during the housing crisis. And we always, at least like in America, because that's, you know, where it was the major like focus of where it happened, like we don't really see how it affected the rest of the world, and we kind of forget, like, oh yeah, that fucked over the entire housing market, not just America's. And that's something I really like about the movie, is it's exploring, like, yeah, because everyone's, that's one thing I really like about the movie, because it's also like, yeah, it kind of leaves on an ultimately sort of bitter note of the film, considering the time period it takes place in. And I really like that about the movie. There's also this overlooming dread of, like, everyone on the news is talking about, you know, oh, we're at an economic high, you know, life's great, you know, everything's wonderful, you should buy houses right now, nothing bad is gonna happen in the next year and a half, you know, kind of thing, and which is stuff we heard a lot during right before the recession, you know. Yep. it's something that really, like, it's fairly like on the nose, but it still comes off really poignant in a way.
It does,
because it's something you don't really expect from a slasher film like this. Not to throw down the slasher genre at all, they can have some very smart and interesting storytelling, but it's something a little different that you don't really expect from the gore fest that this movie also is.
Yeah, that's what I meant, why this movie is very introspective, and I do like how we kind of, we don't exactly, sometimes slasher movies end on a somewhat happy note. This one kind of is ambiguous, but not exactly happy.
This one ends, without spoiling it, this one ends on a seemably happy note, and then it kind of sets in everything that's about to happen in the world, and then you're like, oh shit, you're fucked.
And was it worth it in the end?
Yeah, was it all worth it?
You know, which is a moral question. Yeah, this is a very interesting movie on that end, because I think it can please both audiences. This is one of those films that, even though you could say this is film for two very different audiences, because if you just want to go in and have a fun slasher gory and not go too deeply, this movie is very serviceable.
This is a service issue, yeah.
This will do it. But if you want to go and look, and one of the things I liked about it is it's not just for herself. In fact, I doubt that this whole dream of her house, mostly she wants to do it because she made a promise to her mother, and her mother died before she could buy her the flat, and then her bastard father, who wasn't a particularly good dad, and I told you, maybe her decision that she makes with the father ultimately, maybe she would have had a tougher time with that decision if he had been a better dad.
You know,
just saying,
you know, you don't have daddy issues.
because I like that, but I like that how she just kind of finally, you know, but she's not really doing it for, and even her brother, she wants to make a better life for these people. It's not, she's not a bad character. I mean, even though she kills people, you could argue she's not a bad character. She's trying to do right by her family and honor her mother.
This is just what the world has led her to have to do, because, yeah, she did work hard. She works two dead-end jobs. She makes as much money as she possibly can. She's been saving up for this, but life happens. Sometimes all the work you put into stuff doesn't ever amount to anything.
Yeah, and she's a responsible girl. Like, you usually see movies where the responsible people, you know, if you work hard, you get what's coming to you. You see, I like how the movie sets it up, because she has her peers, and they're like, oh, I don't want to pay a mortgage anyway. Let's go out and spend frivolously on, you know, alcohol and booze. Mm-hmm. And she's like, no, I'm saving for a flat. And on a lot of these movies, she would get rewarded without having to go to the extreme measure she does, but in this one, no. And life sometimes is like that, and I like that this movie, even though it does go very over the top, there is a lot of realism in this one.
Yeah,
as well.
It very much is. And then one thing I really find interesting about the movie is, yeah, it's a slasher film where our main character is also the one doing the killings, which is something you very, very rarely see, and even rarely see it in the way that this movie handles it. Usually when you see that, it's in more of a comedic sense, like a Rise of Leslie Vernon or You Might Be the Killer style, where it's a bit more more comedic and tongue-in-cheek, like, oh no, I think I might be slashing a slasher killer. Oh no, we're a documentary crew following a slasher killer. You know, it's something like that. Whereas, no, this is just, we're following them on their spree, you know, just following them as a character. Not really judgingly either. We're just following them, like, just matter of fact, like, this is how their life is. This is what they're doing in order to achieve their life, their goals in life, you know?
Exactly. And like, you don't really judge her, which is interesting because one of the people she murders is
a pregnant woman. They kill a pregnant woman. That's the second kill in this fucking movie, and she dies brutally.
But it's also genius. I'm not going to spoil it, guys, but god damn it, that's a creative kill there. I mean, what you can do with a vacuum cleaner, my god. Mm-hmm. It kind of reminds me of the Bolarama film.
Gutter Balls, yeah.
Yeah, it reminds me a lot of Gutter Balls in a sense because some of these kills are very ingenious. And if you're just here, if you guys are like, dudes, it's Halloween. We don't want to be introspective and deep.
We just want to see innocent people die horribly.
Fair enough. This movie's got your back because this is one thing we've been neglecting, but the kills are really brutal and fun. And like I'm saying, you want to see gore, this movie has you covered. It's covered in intestines, guys.
Literally. Literally, the movie has intestines everywhere. There's one kill that I really like where somebody's hiding under a bed and then they pull out the mattress and they're stabbing through the bed frame. It's sort of reminiscent of like that movie that John Carpenter did with the guy in the white mask and the closet scene, but like it's inverted. It's a really cool aesthetic, honestly. Like, it's something like, I'm sure there's movies that have done this kind of scene before too, but I can't think of any, and it's such a simple scene. It's just somebody stabbing on top of a bed frame, but it looks really cool visually, and it's a cool aesthetic for a movie that really sticks out in your mind.
It really does, and like I said, there's a lot of tongue-in-cheek little bit of humor in it, and just stuff that you, I mean, if this isn't, some of the kills are a little bit over the top, but I think they wanted it that way because they know that horror fans
want this. Oh yeah, because that's one thing, because this movie was made in Hong Kong, home of the over-the-top Hong Kong action movies. Whee! And this movie was very much a send-up to that genre. The production team, one of their main influences on this movie was Ricky O, The Story of Ricky, which anybody who knows what that fucking movie is should know the kind of over-the-top fucking kind of kills we have in this movie. And yeah, they go about as hardcore as those do. No! Ah! Ah!
Don't kill me! Yeah, and this is a perfect movie for Halloween, guys. It really, or the spooky season. It really is, and I feel, because I didn't know, but Christian knew about this movie. I didn't, and I think this would be something, if you've been meaning to check out like we have, or if you've never heard of this and you really like your gore aesthetics, I would definitely put this one at the top of the pile, especially if you're looking for newer stuff, like stuff you haven't seen a million times.
Yeah, I would definitely say, like, this is a total hidden gem of a movie. Like, if you've ever wanted, like, if you've ever wanted a Hong Kong take on something like Inside that also has like weirdly deep social commentary about like how we treat people trying to achieve their goals and everything, that's basically what this is.
But this movie has you covered on so many levels, guys, and it really is fun. And I think it's, and like Christian said, this is one that is not talked about. Do you have any really big cons with the film?
Not really. I actually really dug the hell out of the movie. Like, it's not an all-time like classic. I will say this is a total hidden gem of a movie though.
Yeah,
like,
I would agree.
You know, like, it's, and no, I guess, like, know who you are going into it if you don't like foreign films or if you don't like the this kind of kind of movie. But I feel like if we're talking about, you know, with the movies that this is like, you know, stuff like Inside and stuff, I feel like you're probably gonna feel like no immediately if you're gonna like the movie or not. It's a great little flick that I can totally recommend. It pops up on Shudder every now and again, so maybe if you get lucky and find it on there. We're filming this a little bit in advance, so I don't know if it's on, is set to be on there, if it's on Shudder at the moment, but might be. It was up last October, so maybe check it out if so.
And there's always ahoy, mateys!
Yeah,
there's always other ways to get your
medium. There's other ways. Yeah, do you have any cons with the film overall?
I actually actually don't. I actually was really engaged with this one. I thought it, I really, my biggest praises for this film is definitely the gore. And I do like the social commentary. And I was kidding, but I'm not actually. This movie really does represent a woman doing it on her own. She don't need no man. And one of the things I like is she has this loser, nerdy kind of boyfriend that's a fucking dick. And at the end of the movie, she tells him to get lost, asshole. And that was a very empowering moment and a character arc.
So what you're saying is if you in the audience have ever wanted to mix Inside with 9 to 5,
exactly,
this is the movie for you.
Show your daughters is what I'm saying.
This is the only thing missing is a kick-ass Dolly Parton song for this, but otherwise, yeah, that's pretty much what this flick is.
And show your daughters, because I almost forgot, there's a great scene where she severs a penis and throws it at a prostitute, and I think that is so important for girls to see penises at a young age.
What? Yeah, so this has been Dream Home. We both like the movie. Can recommend the movie.
I would give this a solid B plus.
Yeah, it's a pretty good movie. Yeah, so
and it's an in gem and it has hidden penises.
Yeah, so yeah, Dream Home. Ask for it by name. We'll see you tomorrow for some other movie. I don't know. I'm very uncomfortable now. Goodbye. You need help in a psychological sense. You need help.